how could someone so charming and so charismatic be accused of such horrible crimes?
Locked up in Lee County, accused of murdering a prominent doctor in her home. Now NBC2 is learning Curtis Wayne Wright has been on the radar of police in Missouri for decades, long before he was ever accused of killing Teresa Sievers.
Wright is the prime person of interest in the disappearance of a man nearly 20 years ago.
NBC2's Trent Kelly went to Missouri to uncover new details in the case. Trent?
Well, Peter and Kelly, we all know Wright by now. He's, of course, the 47-year-old IT specialist from Missouri who was arrested in the brutal death of Dr. Teresa Sievers. But as I found out, that may not be the first case he's ever had a hand in.
I feel like my family deserves answers for whatever happened 19 years ago.
Deep in the rolling hills of Missouri lies a mystery.
Nobody really knew what to think.
One that's been growing for nearly 20 years.
He's not going to come home, but they keep hoping he will.
And the only person who may be key to solving it is in Southwest Florida.
Clearly there's a dark side in there.
Greg Boland grew up in Hillsboro, a small town about an hour's drive south of St. Louis. There, he and his brother Ronnie, along with their four other brothers, became close with a young man named Curtis Wright.
His full name is Curtis, but everybody calls him Wayne.
Greg says Wright was a nice guy, liked by nearly everyone. The two graduated high school together in 1986.
I once considered him one of my best friends. My dad loved him like a son. You know, it was kind of a running joke that he was the seventh son.
But that all changed in July of 1996 when Ronnie suddenly disappeared. The last person to see him, the seventh son.
It was hard on all of us. We just so shocked to learn that someone so close to our family was the last known person to see him.
Is he alive?
Jan Stumball is a longtime friend of the Bolands.
I've watched the Bolands just hope and pray that somewhere out of nowhere he would show up.
But that never happened. According to Greg, Curtis Wright owed his brother money, about $1,500.
He just said he was going to get the money that Wayne owed him one way or another.
On that night, Ronnie disappeared. When deputies went to question Wright, he was nowhere to be found. His family telling detectives Wright went on a vacation to Florida and to talk to his lawyer if they had any questions.
My opinion changed when he refused to talk to the police.
Time passed, the investigation slowed. Without a body, deputies hit a dead end. The trail went cold for nearly two decades.
Two Missouri men are arrested
until the murder of Dr. Teresa Sievers.
The same person keeps popping up in, you know, event after event.
As Wright now sits in the Lee County Jail charged with her murder, Greg Boland says there's no doubt in his mind what happened to Ronnie.
Do you think Curtis Wayne Wright had something to do with your brother's disappearance?
Yes, I do. My instinct tells me that somehow, some way, he is directly responsible for whatever happened to my brother.
Now, Teresa's husband, Mark Sievers, grew up in that very same Missouri town. I asked Greg Boland if he knew Mark. He says while the two would bump into each other occasionally while growing up, Greg says he never really got to know Mark very well. Live in the studio tonight, Trent Kelly, NBC2.
Trent's investigation does not stop there. Tonight at 11, hear from the Missouri cold case detective in charge of solving the Ronnie Boland case.